Hey everyone, it's Boone again. The other day, I got a very interesting comment on one of my YouTube videos by the user Emotional Machine, and they asked me to describe, without using gender stereotypes, how I define being a woman. And it really got me thinking about womanhood and how I knew that I was a girl and why I felt so strongly about it from such an early age and how I was even able to find a distinction between how I was perceived and how I felt I actually was in terms of gender. You know, it's a big question. And so after trying to formulate a response, I realized I could do so in a much more detailed way on a YouTube video, and I thought it'd make for an interesting little discussion. So I don't have a real script for this, like I never do. It's just sort of going to be my thoughts coming at you in journal format, but I thought it was something that, you know, I had some interesting things to say on, and I thought maybe some of y'all would be interested in hearing those thoughts. So, without further ado, I'd like to time travel back to maybe 2010, earlier, just into my early childhood in general, and explore sort of in more detail, because I have talked about this on this channel a bit before, just explore in more detail how I came to the realization that I was a girl and what that felt like. And what that means to me now. So going back, way back, I've been homeschooled my entire life, my entire childhood. I never went to brick and mortar school. My mom taught me and my three brothers everything. I have three older brothers, no sisters. So that was the household. I have, you know, my dad. I live with my dad my whole life too, but most days, like for the majority of time when he was at work, it would be my mom and my three brothers. And, you know, not going to a school with boys and girls and like having separation by gym class and those kinds of things, and just having kind of more stereotypes and like social fixtures and structures kind of thrown at me. Not having that, I feel like it probably took me longer to realize I was a girl than it would have if I did go to school, which is interesting. But when I think about how I eventually did come to the conclusion, it wasn't through analyzing my own behavior. It wasn't through analyzing stereotypes of gender and perceptions about what a guy should be and what a girl should be that made me realize I was a girl. Yes, I wanted to get Polly Pockets, and for my 7th birthday, I asked for that. And yes, I wanted to play dolls and play dress up and wear Uggs with my friends who were girls at the age of 9, but it wasn't that. It wasn't me looking at that and thinking, hey, that must make me a girl. That's not how I realized that. That's not how I felt connected to that aspect of gender. It was much more internal, and I feel like the earliest times when I started to really make that connection, it was completely unrelated to that behavior. Yes, I noticed that. Yes, I picked up on the fact that my interests and behavior was more traditionally feminine, like that's how people perceived it. But it wasn't that, you know, I knew that I could still like those things and be a guy. I knew that there were guys who liked more girly things, and they still totally felt that they were guys. And I played video games, and I watched, like, cartoons and stuff that, like, were more geared towards boys, I suppose. And that, you know, it wasn't me taking a look at those behaviors and comparing it to the other things I was interested to kind of create this prototype of a woman and decide that was who I was. I think that, you know, when I first started feeling dysphoria, it was just more coming into being around more girls and more guys and realized that I was being linked in with the boys more. And I was just, you know, I was referred to with male pronouns and male names and titles. And I was kind of being forced into this identity that I knew didn't feel right for me. And like I said, it wasn't about clothing and it wasn't about toys or anything like that. Like, I didn't need to consider stereotypes to define womanhood, and I don't need to now. Like, I can't tell you what being a woman is. I can't even tell you what gender is. I can just tell you that from a very early age, I felt very strongly that I wanted to be seen more similarly to the way my mom was seen than to the way that my dad was seen. I knew that, like, my brothers and I had a lot of similarities. We bonded over playing video games and we bonded over watching TV shows, and I could be rambunctious and have a lot of similarities to them. I did karate, etc. You know, we shared a lot of similarities, but I still didn't want to be seen as a boy. I didn't mind being seen as someone who shared interests with them. I didn't mind having a closeness with them, and I just didn't want to be seen as their brother. The more time I spent hanging out with my female friends, I realized that there was something that we shared, and it wasn't our common interest in Polly Pockets, but there was something we shared on a more internal level that made me realize something was off. And over time, over the course of years, I realized that I was transgender and that I just was a girl. And my access to that was going to be different. But yeah, you know, after thinking about this for a decent amount of time and really reflecting on my experiences, I'm not in a position where I feel like I really can define womanhood. I think everyone has a different definition of it, and that's super cool. All I can say is that my whole life, and as I've grown up, I've always felt an attachment to it, whatever it is. And it's always been very internal. It hasn't been related to stereotypes. Yes, society's definition of womanhood and the way we kind of try to box people of the male gender and people of the female gender into these stereotypes and these ideas, you know, me looking at that, I guess, has helped sort of realize that the one box is easier for me than the other, but it's not those stereotypes and the societal pressures that make me feel like I am who I am. I just know that I'm a girl. It's just a feeling. And it's super hard to explain. I don't think that I really can. I think that it's just kind of like a leap of faith. You have to realize that this is how I've always perceived myself. It's how I understand myself to be true. And as soon as I was able to start expressing that I'm a girl, whether it was verbally through what I did, or how I, how I talked, I felt 100% more comfortable with myself. And yeah, so that's really all I can say on the matter. This isn't one of my longer videos. I've recorded a few takes, and honestly, each one's been as messy as the last, so I think I'm gonna end it here and say that it's a messy thought process. It's a big question, and I don't really have a sturdy, stable definition of what it means to be a girl. This is just how I've learned to accept myself and understand myself over time, and I hope me talking about it has been beneficial or at least entertaining for some of you. Thank you very much, Emotional Machine, for asking the question, because it was fun for me to think about, and it was fun for me to answer in this video. So, I've got some other ideas for videos coming up, and hopefully, y'all stay tuned. Thank you for watching this, and I will see you shortly with another video.